Since this is round, we really can't square it up, but eyeball it. It looks. Crunch bang. That's pretty damn good. Put a good tack here on the back side and then weld the whole way around. Thank you.
when I was building, I forgot to hit record on the camera a couple times, so there's a lot of footage missing, which gives me a chance to just sit down and explain all this to you. That way, the rest of the video, I don't have to do any talking at all. I can just work. These shafts have a 2x2x1/8 inch piece of plate welded to the other end of them. I stuck them in through that hole, out this hole, and then welded them around. When the frame gets slid over this, there's going to be an end plate welded on here. That way, if this weld ever breaks, the end plate and the plate that's in here will capture this, and it won't pull out of here, and then this thing swings out free and rolls down my hillside into someone's car, my house, or someone else's house. This opening is this so big because I'm filling it with sand. I don't ever want to have to empty it in the wintertime. Once I fill it with sand, it's done. It holds something like between 700 and 1,100 pounds of sand somewhere in there. And this is my draw bar, right? This goes through here. I want this draw bar to pivot a little bit. That way when you're going up and down these rolling hills that I have, it's not putting weight all the way at the end of, or like a lot of force on the end of the tongue and bending the tongue on the quad. And everywhere that there's a pivot, like here and here, I'm gonna drill and tap for an 1/8 inch grease fitting so I can grease all of this stuff. So the way this works, I'm gonna drill holes in here and rosette weld this to these right here. So this will go something like that. Your end cap gets welded on. This will already be in one of these welded. Okay? Then this gets slid on. Then my pre-drilled holes will be in this piece on here. I will slide this onto here. Hard to do. Slide this onto here. This onto here. Right? Something like that. I'll have to bang everything together because it's all cockeyed and crooked now. And actually, something's bent. So I'm going to have to do some straight and see how it's going like that. These must have pulled when I welded them and I didn't pay attention to it. Or I just welded them crooked because I was in a hurry. Either or, we'll fix it. But that's how it's gonna go. There will be an end cap welded on here and here, grease fitting. This will pivot, rosette welded here and here. Filled with sand, 700 to 1,100 pounds, flatten out the yard. Yeah, right? Okay, no more talking, nothing but work. See you later. We'll soon over here on the workbench sometime, right? Bye.
Jake, watch out. You're going to get burnt. Watch out. got it. Right there's 650 pounds of sand. Let's weld the cap on it and we'll test her out. So I took it out and I tested it out and it did okay, not great. There's some things I gotta change on it, like this hitch. I gotta do something different with this hitch. I gotta make this deeper and it wider. So it's really hard to hitch up. And I bent it like that with a pry bar so it would go on there easier. And I wanna make something, some type of swivel in here so that this can roll back and forth when this thing goes, you know, that way over hills. And I'm having trouble with these ends. So this is the factory end that was welded, you know, when the thing was made. And what's happening is it's splitting here. It's on the other side. I already welded it, but it's splitting behind the weld. This head is inset in here like that far. Well, that's where it's splitting. This thing's flexing a whole bunch because it's not real thick. So it's flexing and it's splitting, and the same thing's happening over here. This is the head that I cut off and I set in, and it's set in probably not quite as far, but it's splitting right here too. And that's just one big weave pass I put over it to cover it. You blow through this shit real easy because it's super thin. And I have a blacktop driveway, but there's a lot of rocks in it because I don't ever clean it. And when you run over the rocks, it actually pokes holes in this thing.
So I'm going to, I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm not going to give up on it because I got a lot of time and I got $50 worth of sand in this thing. See if I can see. Well, I don't feel like moving anything, so I'm not going to show you this one down here. But what I'm going to do is I ordered one of those video camera glasses that you wear. So when I do all the repairs on this, I'm just going to wear those. That way all the welding and stuff that I do, it'll be like you're welding with me. It'll be right there. You'll be looking through the helmet with me. I don't know if it's going to work, but we'll try it. So that's that. I don't know. I wouldn't recommend making one of these out of a hot water tank after all the shit that this thing's doing to me. I mean, I have to, I have some 1/8 inch thick by 2 inch flat stock. I'm going to weld across here to stiffen that up. And then I actually think I'm going to sleeve the whole outside of this because I have some 1/8 inch plate. But my ring roller won't do a piece of plate. It'll only do flat stock. So I got a buddy that has a machine shop. I'm going to see if he'll roll it for me. That thing, this is 18 1/4 in diameter. So that comes out to be like 57-inch circumference or 58-inch circumference, something like that. So we'll figure something out. But like I said, when I do it, I'll bring you guys along with my new POV glasses. So thanks for watching. Have fun.